right, another improv session in bag. Yay! This is Manomin Park. I'm probably pronouncing it right or wrong. Maybe I'm right, I don't know. Manomin Park, it's where Rice Creek meets the Mississippi River. If you recall, I did an improv session a long time ago, earlier this summer, at Rice Creek Regional Trails. It was probably 5 or 6, 7 miles east of here. And yeah, so I was like looking for a place to play, and it was really warm today. It was almost 90 degrees, and I was like, yeah, 90 degrees Fahrenheit, not Celsius. And I thought about this place, and I knew that the river dumped out here. I knew kind of about this location, but then when I came and scouted it out, I was like, oh my God, there are rapids here. I'm like, this sounds like the place to be. So here I am. So the place doesn't really bear any significance to me, like some of the other locations, you know, that are have personal meaning. This place doesn't really have a attachment for me, but it is a very nice little park. It's, and the fact that it dumps right onto the Mississippi River, just like around this bend, it is the Mississippi. I've already done a few recordings, a few improv sessions, basically on the banks of the Mississippi. The Mississippi winds through a lot of areas here in Minnesota. In fact, it starts in Minnesota. If you're not familiar with your geography, this way far north, and I forget the name of the city or the name of the town, way far north, the Mississippi begins as a spring. It's like a spring coming up onto the ground. And over the course of hundreds of miles, every little river, creek, whatnot, kind of empties out into the Mississippi, for better or for worse. I say for worse because, you know, that's, I'm thinking of pollution, of all of the toxins and the things that are, you know, like I'm thinking of like pesticides and fertilizers and lawn fertilizer stuff, and all of that goes to create a not so clean Mississippi River. And it does kind of break my heart, you know, but this is the world we live in. We don't quite know how to take care of these nice things that we have, namely nature and our habitat. If you watch the Crown Arts video, I talked a little bit about my motivation behind doing all this. Oh, there goes my postcards. That my motivation is really steeped in. I'm really trying to stretch myself, become more comfortable playing out and about. And just getting used to, like, allowing my body to get used to the idea of being in uncomfortable situations. You know, I'm thinking of playing in front of people. That's pretty uncomfortable for me. It's only because it's been forever. But I'm slowly getting used to the idea. And so it's a stretching thing for me, right? But I tell you, so side thought that contributes to this, I'm taking a course called The Artist's Way, and highly recommend it. I really highly recommend it. Like, if you are an artist of any sort, or a creative person of any sort, everyone's a creative person if you really dig deep, you know. And the book is like a 12-week course that helps you unblock your creative self. Because our natural state is an unblocked state. It's just that we acquire all of this hardship, the insecurities, the cultural things that we're exposed to. We start to get really bogged down by all of these things, and they make us feel less than a human being. They make us feel guilty for wanting to be an artist or creating. Anyways, the book has been entirely helpful for me. And part of my exercise, part of my own personal journey, is getting rid of all of the things that are blocking me from doing stuff like this and doing it without fear. Doing it without any sort of hindrance. To come into this with full confidence that I'm gonna be okay. That even if I mess up, it's fine. We're all human beings. In fact, this is something that I'm trying to work into my lexicon as an artist, is that there's no such thing as perfect music. There's no such thing as a perfect musician. We're all gonna screw up sooner or later. And I think it comes down to how comfortable we are we with the notion, that notion that we're not gonna be perfect when we create. We are gonna screw up. And this music here is all improv by nature. Like, it's, all right, I'm just gonna make something up and just run with it and see what happens. There is a hell of a lot of risk involved with that, because stuff doesn't always work out routinely. Like, there's usually one or two compositions that, you know, in the course of recording an hour's worth of improv, probably a good 20 minutes of it is just like, nah, I don't need to share that. But it's, I don't know, it's this exercise of just getting out there and create. If you are a painter and painting is your thing, but you feel like, oh, like you can't get started, like the canvas is so intimidating and things like that, half of the step is just starting. Just start putting anything on the canvas. If you're a musician, just start making something. Just don't judge yourself. Don't judge the work. In fact, there is no real place for judging the work. The work should just stand on its own, and it is what it is. It is what it becomes. And it's fine, completely fine, if it's not good. It doesn't have to be good. Good will come with time. Good comes with time and practice. But you are an artist. You are a creator. And if you are waiting for some sort of success or some sort of perfection before you can call yourself an artist, you're fooling yourself. We are all artists. We are all creative people. We've all been blessed with this thing inside of us from the universe. Like, I believe there's this creative energy in the universe, and that it's just right there waiting for us. Waiting for us to use what's within inside of us, and to not get so hung up on, will this sell? Or are people going to like this? You know what? If you can't see through the mistakes to the beauty of just being here in this space and creating, well, this stuff is not for you, and that's okay. I'm so okay with that. I'm getting better at being okay with that too. I used to really be hung up with imposter syndrome, hung up on perfectionism. I still am a little bit, you know, I get trapped every now and then. But it's not about being perfect, and it's not about making music or art that's going to sell. It's fine if you want to do that. But that is not a prerequisite to be an artist, to being a creative person, to doing something worthwhile. You can just go out and make something just for the sake of making it. And that's really where it's at, you know? That's where your priorities should be. You know, making money with your art is fine. There's nothing wrong with it, but it can quickly become a trap. And can quickly become a paralyzing thing, and a thing where you lose your joy because things don't sell well or people aren't responding to it as well. It's a difficult road to get out of if you're really stuck on success, if you're really stuck on being a, you know, things panning out to be a career musician or to be a career artist. You know, we're not guaranteed that any sort of success. I mean, you can even follow a 12-step plan for success and shit's still gonna go wrong. Not everything is gonna go perfectly. But, so the author of The Artist's Way, she said something like this. You worry about the quantity, and God, the maker, the creator, the universe, source, whatever you want to call it, however you understand the higher power to be, the universe will worry about the quality. That's not for us to necessarily worry about. I mean, we can practice as much as we want, work on refining our craft. But we have to show up. We have to do the work day in, day out. And a work of love, of reaching in within yourself and looking to the universe around you and examining your feelings, examining what you see and perceive about the world, and use that as your source of inspiration and just create. Create your response to the world, and the universe will take care of the rest. I have to tell you this. Because there is a high degree of truth to this. One of the things that I've been experiencing now that I've been out and about, this is, I don't even know how many performances, public things this has been, probably less than a dozen. I think I've got about 6, 7, or 8 of these in the bag now. And the past few times, people have actually started coming up to me and start just breaking out into a dialogue and just conversations about music, about nature, about what the hell I'm doing out here. And there have been people that have just been really touched by the experience. I'd like walking down the trail and then, whoa, there's music here. And it's right in the middle of this stream with these rapids and stuff. Like, wow, what a surprise. And they'll come and sit down and they'll just listen. And then in between songs, we'll strike up a conversation and exchange names. And which, by the way, if you are starting to branch out, get out and perform, even if it's just like what I'm doing in nature by yourself, bring freaking postcards or something or stickers that allows people to connect with you, because that's been starting to happen on a more frequent basis. One-on-one connections with people about this music, about what I'm doing here. And it, the same can happen for you. You just got to get out there and do it. Anyway, I got to finish up packing and then head off to some other things tonight. So thank you, my friends, for listening so much. Thank you for your support. I appreciate you very much. Namaste and blessings to you. Bye.
Good, how are you?
Good, that was beautiful. It's so beautiful, I love it. You're still saying the pads,
thank you, yeah.
Awesome. I'm a musician.
Oh, you are?
Yes.
What do you play?
Well, I'm a bass player.
Oh, you're a bass player, okay. Bass player. Cool.
So,
are you doing anything with your music?
Yes, I have some music on Spotify.
Okay.
And I've been lately playing like relaxed music, but slowly.
Yeah.
I work for the post office.
Yeah. But, everyone's got their hustle that they gotta pay for their passion, you know.
Exactly.
That's the way it works.
Cool. Yeah. All right, I'll follow you and write to you later.
Yeah. Yeah. Please do.
Sweet. Thank you.
Yeah. My name is Michael, by the way.
Oh, Michael. I'm Jared.
Jared.
Aaron. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm Jessica.
Jessica.
Nice to meet you both.
Yeah. Nice to meet you too. Yeah.
Cool.
Oh yeah.
All right. I'll see you around.
All right. Take care, man.
Thank you. Have a good one.
You too.